Good morning, everyone. Welcome to LSC Online Live Class. Today we are going to start our class with grade 7 and our subject is social studies. We hope we can complete our syllabus during our time before the second semester with your proper concentration. Good morning, Omar and Fahima.
Good morning,
guys. How are you both? I'm also fine. So today we are going to start with our social studies again. So do you have your book with you?
Yeah.
Very good. So we can tell you where were we, what we read in the previous class? Fahima, do you remember what we read in the previous class? Omar, what you read?
Chapter 8.
You are reading chapter 9, Rights of Senior Citizen and Human Rights, right? We have finished chapter 8
and
you are already.
Eight.
Yeah, we have finished chapter 8 and you are already commanded to make an assignment on that.
Oh, chapter, yeah, right? Ma'am, we finished chapter 8.
Okay, anyway. So let's see what we are going to make today in our worksheet. Then we have come back today. Can you see the worksheet, both of you? Okay, very good. So today we are going to read the chapter 9, Rights of Senior Citizens. Chapter 9, Rights of Senior Citizens and Women in Bangladesh. First, we'll discuss the three pages. Then we'll go for some following questions. And after that, we'll read some identified true or false. As we don't have much time, so we'll read a little more. After the true or false, we'll read some matching, okay? So this is all about our today's class. Let's start with our chapter. What do you want to open? You have to open page 89. Both of you, please open page 89. Have you opened page 89? Both of you? Okay, so our topic is today, lesson 2, problems of the senior citizens. So what are the problems of that? They have to face some familial, some economic, some physical, some social, culture, and psychological problems. What can be the familial problem? When you live in a small family, you have not much space. You don't have much space or you don't have much money to survive yourself. And when the elder also try to live with you, you can't tolerate them. That's some familial problem that the senior citizen always face. Okay. Now the economic problem. As a senior citizen, they can't do any work or they don't have much things to earn. That's why they have to face some economic problem. They have to face some economic problem. Then the physical problem. When you get old, you have to survive with some diseases, right? Your physical situation is not so stable. You have some weakness, so they have to face some physical problem. Socio-cultural problem. Socio-cultural problem. What is this? This is very important thing. When you become old, you can't manage or cope up with the real time or the maintain time. They have some old mentality, right? So they can't manage with our social culture. So at the old age, they have to face some socio-culture problem. And number 5 is psychological problem. When you have to face a lot of things, you can't survive properly, quietly. You are feeling so irritated by yourself. That is called some psychological problem. So how many problems you face, Omar, in the old age? What are the senior citizens' problems?
Hello, ma'am. Hello.
Omar, I'm using your phone to answer.
Hello, hello. Hello.
Hello, Fahmi. Please bring your social studies book and turn on your camera.
Okay, ma'am.
6 problems, ma'am.
5 problems, Omar. That's written in...
Oh, 5 problems. Yeah, yeah, 5 problems.
What are that?
Right to flourishing of their talent.
Not that.
Not that.
Listen to page 89. There are 3 to 5 problems. What?
Oh, yeah. Familial problem, economic problem, physical problem, socio-cultural problem, psychological problem.
Psychological.
Problem.
How are you? What?
Yes, assalamu alaikum, ma'am. How are you?
Assalam, fine. What about? You are only 15 minutes late, right?
What, ma'am?
You are only 15 minutes late, why?
Because I woke up late.
Very good. So we are doing the social circle. Do you have
Jabil Jamai, guys?
So now we are going to read about lesson 3. What is written in lesson 3? Welfare program for the senior citizen in Bangladesh. Fami, can you hear me?
Yeah.
So please look at the front. Right. So what is the welfare program? As all the seniors are very much disappointed about the system, the system of Bangladesh, with the system of their family, the culture, so the government and non-government program is organized for them. What is that? The non-government program. There are a handful of organizations in the private sector that work the welfare of the senior citizens. Probin Hitoishi Shongho or Jora Bidgan organization. Okay, so what is that? The non-government organization? Probin Hitoishi Shongho or Jora Bidgan organization. This organization is situated in Shere Banganagar, Dhaka. Its activities include medical treatment facilities, rehabilitation, recreation, observance of religious festivals, etc. Besides, this organization has established a library for the seniors. So, do you know any library that is work for the general public? Can you say a name of a library? Don't you ever hear about the Dhammavan library?
No. I'm not sure the name.
A library that is always in a car. All the books always in a car, and some can purchase or some can read the book from there. Okay, by collecting that. As like that, for the senior people, Probin Hitoishi Shongho established a library. Bangladesh Retired Government Employees Welfare Organization. This organization provides monetary facility to the senior of education and health issue of the mission zero interest loan. Now about the government program. What is the government program? Government program has 3 programs. One is called pension, one is allowance for senior citizens, and number 3 is allowance for destitute, widows, and separate women. It's very hard to read that they give a very small amount to the senior citizens. Okay? But they give something. First, that the pension allowance. Employees of government, state government, and our autonomous bodies get pension certificates when they retire or die. It is a long-term social security. When an employee goes to a retirement after a specific year, the government service, he or she gets the allowance. You know about the government allowance, right? The retirement, pension, you know about that or not? Habiba, do you know about the pension? Have you ever heard about pension? Omar, have you
pension
ever heard about
pension? Annuity?
Yes.
Something have like that. I just heard the name, but I don't know anything about
it. Okay, Fami, do you know something about that?
What?
What is pension?
I think the yearly money they will give by like 1 month.
The government, okay, I guess Jabil knows something about pension. No. Mashfi? What is pension? Fahima? At least you can answer. No. Okay. What is pension? When you are in a government service, a small amount of your salary will be deducted from your month, from every month's salary. And when you retire from your job, the government give you a lot from that allowance, that's called pension. And for that stress, some senior citizen can survive their life easily. They can bear their medical expenses.
Oh yeah, like above 60 years when they get retired.
Exactly. After retirement, they get the pension. So this is a government program for the senior citizen. The second one, allowance for the senior citizen. What is that? The program is run for the benefit of senior over the country. For the neglected poor, it is for the poor. Because all poor people doesn't have a government job. So what government do for the poor people? 10 elderly people of each work in minimum was awarded 100 taka per month. How many money? How much money? It's 100 taka per month. Okay? The government is 100 taka. And number three, allowance for destitute, widows and separated women. The widows women get also some allowance for the government, and this is also the 100 taka, and it has no age. Okay? So this is all the government program for the poor people, for the senior citizens. As we don't have much time, so let's go to our worksheet, then we'll come back to our book if we have time. So this is our worksheet. Can all of you see the worksheet?
Yes.
Can all of you see the worksheet? Okay, thank you. And you can see the worksheet. So what we are reading? We are reading about chapter 9. And we have already discussed these three cases, page 9 to 91. Now we are going to answer the following question that we have already discussed. What is our question here? Farmin, what is the question here? Farmin? Unmute yourself. Yeah, what is the question here?
Mention the problem faced by the elderly people, right?
Yes. Elderly people. Okay, you can find your answer from page 89. Just all of you look at page 89, listen to.
Problems of the senior citizens. Those one.
All of you. Listen to problem of the senior citizen. This is actually the answer of this question. Here is 5 points. You have to write at least 2 or 3 lines from every point. Okay? You get it? From where you can answer it? Any of you have any problem?
Yeah, me. Where to get it? Like from page 89 to 91, this must be like answer.
Ma'am, this much big answer.
No, it's not. You have to point this 5 points and you have to write 1 or 2 lines, including the point. Okay?
Oh, 1 line. No, that's not.
1 or 2 lines. As I say, that line by your own.
Two lines.
You can write, at least 2 lines that you can answer properly. So, do you have any confusion with this question or answer? Any of you?
No.
Okay, thank you so much. Then we can go to our next topic. Our next topic is identify true or false. First one is for Hamza. Unmute yourself, Hamza. Hamza, unmute yourself.
All rights for human being are written in human rights charter.
Right charter. Okay, final one, number 2.
People above 15 years age usually know as the age in Bangladesh. False.
W, you have to read number 3.
Me.
Yeah, W. Number
3. In our country, our families are now extended families, and that's false.
Coming number 4. Unmute yourself for me, otherwise we can't hear you.
Yeah, before the children with their influence, what is that influent income or ability cannot come to support its come to support their parents in misery and say it's true.
Omar, number 5.
The senior citizens have a lot of scope for recreation and leisure. Wolves.
Must be number six. Must be. Anyway, I guess we disconnected. Fine. I don't know why you always turn off your camera, Fahima and Hadila. What is the problem? Fahima number six, unmute yourself first. Very good.
There are about 3 crores aged people in the country, in this country. False.
False? It's not 3 crores. Okay, Hadila number seven, what's that?
The worksheet is. Seeing the first question.
You have maybe some little problem. Omar, number 7, please.
Jora Pata works for the welfare of senior citizens. True.
Jabin, number 8.
Me?
Yes.
Rotary Club is an organization for each citizen. And that's false.
Amit number 9. Amit.
Me, okay. Number 9, a family does not show equal interest in educating their girl child as their boys do.
Number 10 is for
Mashti.
Unmute yourself.
Yeah. My current was gone. Oh, sorry, electricity.
My current.
The go.
Did
it came now because the fan is moving. Relation towards the woman. True.
Do you have any problem in this true or false? I guess not, as I have already given you the answer. So the matching is left for all today's class. Who will read first? Comment number 1. Match it. And
sorry.
Don't
understand,
yeah. And our answer is
also. Nobody can realize therefore. What? Nobody can realize that. Okay, let's read. Nobody can realize their full potential without their rights.
Omar number 2.
All rights for human beings are written in Human Rights Charter. The United Nations has declared the Senior Citizen Day.
The senior citizens fall prey to loneliness and melancholy.
Sometimes senior citizens become penniless by natural
disaster. Okay, must be number 6.
In Bangladesh, women are lagging behind men in many ways.
Number 7 is for Fahmi.
For me, number 7, it is Begum Rokia was a Begum Rokia was the What is it? Permanent? I can't read it. It's like...
It's forerunner.
Oh, number F. It is number F. Okay. Forerunner, hero for... what is that? Hero for men?
Begum Rukia was the forerunner of women advancement. Begum Rukia was the forerunner of women advancement. Okay? That means she is the leader of women development. Over number 8. Omar, unmute yourself. Why unmute yourself? Why when I ask you the question?
Keep quiet. Napoleon Bonaparte was the French leader and general.
Don't cry.
Oh my God. The unit, the UN Charter prescribes number E, and that's equal rights to men and women.
Number 10, last one.
Education for girls up to higher level.
So, do you have any problem in this? Any matter? No, do you have any problem? Okay, do you need any screenshot?
I did already. Okay.
Ma'am, on social studies, which chapter you gave for attendance?
Our previous chapter, that will be chapter 8. Okay. So if you don't have any problem, then we can stop sharing our worksheet. Okay. Do you have any problem anywhere?
No, ma'am.
I need
do
one
we have
word, like screenshot the second page. I need screenshot the
ma'am.
Yes.
Do we have any assignment for social studies?
Yes, you have the assignment for social studies.
Which
and that
one?
Is from chapter 8.
Chapter 8, which...
Have you done it, Habiba?
Yes, ma'am.
So, whatever we discussed today about the senior citizen, the problem of the senior citizen and the welfare program, do you have any problem here? Any of you? No, Jabil, I know you don't have any problem. That's very nice of you, Jabil. Omar, Mashfi, Habiba, Fahmi.
Ma'am, where is this?
To revise that
ma'am, what is in chapter 8?
No, ma'am,
one?
I don't want to.
Introduction to population of
Bangladesh. Whoever in that class that I gave the assignment, please take from him or her, okay? As the assignment. Always I can't explain the same
did anyone get through?
Obviously, otherwise who am I saying? Obviously, someone in the class, otherwise how can I say, right? But always we can't explain everything again and again. It's very time consuming, right? When we don't have much time. And all of you, please try to be on time. All of you, please try to be on time. Don't get late of 15
minutes. I tried to join, but for the internet connection, I couldn't.
Yeah, you have some little problem. Okay. If you don't have any problem, we can over our class here, right? Okay, all of you, thank you so much. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, ma'am.